Hello friends, how are you all? This is Gurpal Singh and today I'm making this video for giving you information regarding NET and JRF examination. So basically this video is going to be for those students who do not know anything regarding this examination and they really want to know what this examination is about and where they can go if they qualify this examination. So in this video we'll be talking about what is NET, what is JRF, what is the differentiation between two, where you can go if you qualify only NET, what you can do if you qualify JRF and all the details regarding that. I can completely understand that if you are a newcomer, there are large number of questions in your mind for which you would have been searching on Google or you would have been asked to so many people regarding that what is exam is about and why should we pursue, why should we attempt for this examination. So I have made this video in two parts so that I can answer all your queries, all your questions regarding this examination. So in the first part we'll be talking about what is NET, JRF, what is the difference and differentiation between these two, where you can go if you qualify NET and JRF, and what are the eligibility criteria for applying for this examination, and what jobs you can get after qualifying this exam. So I have made presentation on some questions regarding what is NET and JRF exam. These questions usually comes to the newcomers, the new students who are in their post graduation or who have completed their post graduation but they want to make a career in as an assistant professor in university or colleges. So what is National Eligibility Test or NET? As you know that National Testing Agency conduct this exam for two times in a year, first in June and second in December. This exams is the eligibility criteria for applying a job of assistant professor in colleges. So if you qualify National Eligibility Test exam conducted by National Testing Agency, if you qualify this examination, then you are eligible for applying of a job of assistant professor or lecturer in colleges. So basically this exam is about the eligibility criteria of job of assistant professor. So NET is meant only sole for this purpose. Then the second question usually they ask me or they have in their mind is what is JRF? What is JRF? JRF is the dream of thousands of students. JRF is the same exam, the National Eligibility Test. This is the same exam which sets the criteria or which sets the cutoff for two eligibilities. First for assistant professor and second for being a research scholar. If you want to get the job of assistant professor in colleges, then you have to qualify your National Eligibility Test only. But if you want to be a research scholar, PhD research scholar in a university, in any university of the India, then you will have to qualify the Junior Research Fellowship and JRF examination. So basically this is the difference between these two. NET and JRF are being given in a single exam, so you have to attempt for only one exam, but there are two different cutoffs. If your score is equal to the cutoff of only the eligibility of assistant professor or NET, then you are NET qualified. But if your score is more than that and your score crosses the cutoff of JRF, then you are JRF qualified. The exam is only one, but there are two different cutoffs. The purpose is sole of yours. If you want to apply for assistant professor, then NET is sufficient. But if you want to go for PhD or junior research fellowship, then you must score that much marks so that your cutoff, that your score equals to or crosses the cutoff of JRF. So this is about JRF. So what is the difference between these two? You would have cleared by listening my video till now that NET satisfy the eligibility criteria of assistant professor and JRF is for junior research fellowship if you want to pursue your PhD in any university of India. So this is the basic difference between these two. So what are the different benefits of NET and JRF examination? As far as NET is concerned, only one purpose, only the one eligibility is that in any college of the India, you can apply for job of lecturer. So the national eligibility test, as the name national has been attached to eligibility test that satisfies the eligibility criteria throughout India. In any state you can apply for job of assistant professor if you qualify national eligibility test. So this is basically the benefit of NET examination. So what are the benefit of a GRF? So if you qualify GRF, as I have already told you, this is the dream, literally this is a dream of thousands of students of India. They always, just for qualification of a GRF, number of students are there who have already qualified NET, but they are again attempting this examination in order to qualify GRF. So basically the benefit of a GRF is that if you get yourself enrolled in PhD in any university of India, any recognized university of India, then you get a monthly stipend of approximately 35,000 rupees. So this is the benefit of a GRF. Along with your own study, you get money or you get funds as well. So this is the benefit of a GRF exam. NET only satisfy the eligibility criteria for assistant professor, but the GRF satisfy the eligibility criteria for being a research scholar of PhD in any university of India, and in consideration of that you will get monthly stipend of 35,000. So this is the benefit of GRF. Only because of this benefit people do not go usually for the job of assistant professor. They go for doing research or PhD in universities, because for 5 years continuously you will get the stipend of that much amount, and you study your own PhD your own, and for doing that you will be getting the monthly stipend. And what's more, what you need more? So this is the benefit of GRF. So NET satisfy assistant professor eligibility, and GRF satisfies the criteria for being a research scholar. So I have told you that. So finally, what are the eligibility criteria for NET and GRF? What you have to do for applying for this examination? So now I will be talking about eligibility criteria. Eligibility criteria is very simple. So eligibility criteria for this examination is of two type. First is age eligibility and second is qualification eligibility. So first we'll be talking about qualification eligibility. Qualification eligibility means if you are post-graduated or you have already done the first year of your post-graduation, then you can simply apply for this examination. So qualification is basically either first year of your post-graduation should have been completed, or your post-graduation completely should have been completed, so that you can easily apply for this examination. And as far as the age criteria is concerned, if you want to apply only for NET examination, national eligibility test, if you want to appear in this exam only and you do not want to go for a GRF, then age is no bar for any candidate, for any if you are of any age, if you are of 30, you are 35, 40, you can apply for this examination. National eligibility test do not require any kind of age criteria for this examination. But as far as the GRF is concerned, for a general candidate 30 years of age, he should be of 30 or less than 30. Only then you are eligible for applying for this examination. Otherwise, and as far as the reservation is concerned, 5 years relaxation for a different categories of as per your caste is concerned, for different categories of students the age relaxation is given. And as far as the eligibility criteria as concerned, as I told you, either the student who have qualified the first year of their post graduation or they have completed their post graduation. And marks eligibility is also there. You should have got at least 55% marks in your post graduation if you have completed your post graduation, and this criteria is for general student. And as far as reservation is concerned, if you belong to certain caste which have been granted the different reservation by the government, then you have the marks relaxation as well, and this is given in the notification provided by the NTA time to time. So there is marks reservation, there is the age reservation, and these are the basic eligibilities for applying for this post. So as I told you, that we'll be making two videos for this exam. What are the different subjects? These will be discussed in the second video, second part of this video. In this video, I told you regarding the UGC exam, NET exam and JRF, their differentiation, where you can go if you qualify only NET and where you can go if you qualify the JRF exam. I would request you all to subscribe this channel for more videos regarding all over India exam, different kind of examination which are conducted all over India. So this is just a single examination. So this is video part one, in which I gave you information regarding these things and whatever the subject you can opt for and where you can go, how to prepare for NET exam, how to prepare for JRF exam, what should be your strategy, what should be your time management. These kind of things will be discussed in the next part two video of introduction of NET and JRF examination. So subscribe this channel, share this channel, and I hope we'll be in touch forever. Thank you so much. This was Gurpal Singh.